transfer some of that to a different.
We'll get to the budget. It's been that, that department or that court that's been increasing the last, at least 10 years, probably more like 15 years.
In some counties, part of that workload is diverted to the probate court. However, we are currently not in a position to be able to do that.
But our particular situation related to recent developments, we've seen a significant.
Yes, oh yes.
So your sheriff's department budget, this includes your administration, your enforcement, your court control, CID, SID, and the jail as well. This is the general fund portion of all of that. And that increases annually. Animal control, like we said earlier, revenues were up, but the expenditures related to that are more animals that are in there, more animal care we pay for. Road maintenance and construction, there's basically not any for the most part, other than that are typical.
With maintenance, just not for you.
Like, we have tried to use the construction to do any kind of matches. But basically, those are flat, and there's not been a whole lot of capital improvement. We have some capital needs in that department as well. So where are we at this point in the year? We collected about 61% of the revenues, and we're about 56% on expenditures. Don't let that fool you, because we've collected a lot of our revenues already. We do have additional revenues that will come throughout the year, but you've gotten your tax revenues and your property tax revenues in from that part. You're just over 55% on your expenditure side.
So
you said earlier that the tax commissioner is collecting what percentage?
She's not going to collect between 92 and 95% of the percentage.
Overall, it's probably close to 98%.
Right.
Like the first year, it's going to be 92, 95%.
Right.
Then you get those collected.
So we budget for mill, or when we budget property taxes, we anticipate, and when we do our millage as well, we anticipate about 92 and 95% collection.
So Stephanie, what did you tell us on before?
Oh, I'm just saying, don't say, oh, well, we collect more revenues from expenditures. We're doing great.
Yeah, if you look at this and say, well, you know, we've got 6% of our revenue.
We're ahead of the curve, yeah.
We're ahead of the curve now.
That's today.
You'll have more expenditures than revenues towards the end of the year.
Your expenditures are going to continue to come in. Your revenue coming in will be slower than what it was in this first quarter.
Okay, but are you anticipating any problems?
Go back and look at that chart where the lines are like that.
Yeah.
We're anticipating the lines being
Stephanie and Harrison hold our breath to make sure that we are in line.
Okay.
It is literally a razor's edge, because things will come up. Rightfully so.
Yeah.
It could be a sinkhole. It could be something you say,
or you
spend money to do X, Y, or Z. And it was not anticipated in that budget. I've already gotten requests for budget adjustment, and then I will bring that to y'all later. That we have no anticipation that kind of revenue to cover that. Contingency does not be applied percentage wise what we would like to, for it to have been over the last few years to be able to cover this. So this is just telling you, be prepared that we're going to be right again on the razor's edge as far as balancing our budget.
In the past, we've been close to $500,000 in contingency. So when things like sinkholes and all
we've been lucky, we've not had any really significant weather other than the tornado this past year, because there's six departments that get hit hard with expenditures right off the bat. If we have weather from there.
I will comment later in the day for our departments, but we can see issues this week with the anticipated rainfall in all places. Occurs as it is projected early next week. Otter, Ashley, all these people could be here.
So how we balance the budget the last couple of years? We said earlier we never anticipate using fund balance. We just manage our expenditures and our conservative on our revenues and try to keep a good eye on that. But we've had to limit our vehicle and heavy equipment. Can we anticipate using SPLOST to fund those? That didn't happen. We've had limited computer upgrades. We have some departments that have 10-year-old computers. We had, at one point, we were replacing about every 3 years. We moved that to 4 years, and now it's kind of like on a calculated basis. And then almost all the positions that were frozen have a reinstated. Vehicles and equipment, this information is what we put together with our SPLOST and what these departments needed to bring their or just to get their heavy equipment and vehicles into good condition. There was about $1 million from the sheriff's departments and patrol cars. I think they have a number that are over 100,000, and some approaching 200,000. Public Works needs about $1.5 million of equipment, and our department at $1.8 million.
I've got a question, and you may have answered this back earlier and I missed it, but on the drug seized funds, how much of that is used to go to purchase sheriff's equipment?
Because we have not put vehicles in the budget for the last 4 years, all any vehicles purchased by the sheriff's department.
And how much of the drug seize funds go back to the sheriff's department? All of it goes back to,
but they've been down, is what they were saying earlier.
But yeah, those seizures are down.
And it's a percentage of the seizure, too. If you see an article that says they seized $2 million off the interstate, it takes several months for that to go through the court process. When the money comes back, the sheriff's office gets a percentage of that. The state and some other agencies and funds and stuff get there.
No, that goes into our general fund. It all goes back to the sheriff. Whatever portion they get goes back to the sheriff's
court. When you do a seizure, stop, and you are unfortunate enough to catch them after they've made the purchase, you want to go to drugs, not
them. That's right. Send that through the incinerator.
So, literally, that's the person.
We can't go sell that and get our money out of that car.
So, control would be a good idea.
So, that's an issue, obviously, it's part of law enforcement. It's removed from the market, but it does not apply to the
They can't sell it at a discount. Yeah, present value. Market value.
Again, the computers,